think for me, what I really enjoy about dirt compared to tarmac is just the fact that there's so many different ways to get through a corner and there's so many different traction levels. It just makes it a more dynamic surface to race on because there's different ways to brake and power through the corner and exit the corner. It just gives you more of a variety of ways to play the game, and that's what I really enjoy. Well, some of the stages in Dirt 2 have mixed surfaces, such as the Battersea stage, where you're jumping in and out of the building itself, and once you get out, there's some tarmac areas, and there's some dirt areas, and there's jumps, and you really got to notice the ground that the dirt's on, because the traction varies according to the surface. So there's areas where the car will has better grip, on some of the tarmac areas, and then also there's other areas where the car will just slide more. I think that's amazing. There's definitely some stages that we have here in America where, you're on the mix of tarmac and then it changes over to dirt, and you have to be able to identify those areas, obviously with your eyes, and adjust your driving style according to the surface that you're on. Same thing here. There's always a fine balance between too much steering input or too much gas, too much brake, and really to get the best time on some of the courses, you really have to commit and try as hard as you can, and occasionally that'll put you off the road. but that's, part of the fun and part of the challenge is really figuring out the sensitivity of the controller, the sensitivity of the car, how much feedback you really get from the car, the way that it moves on each surface, and then where you can really accelerate to get the most speed down the stage. So sitting here actually playing my own car on the screen, I'm really surprised how well and how dynamic the setup of the car is inside the game and how well it performs really like my real rally car.